So we have updated our application to set the primary photo on clicking of this main button in our previous video. Let's add the functionality to delete a photo on clicking this delete button in this video. So go to the housing service where we will add a new method to delete a photo. Let's add this method just below to the set primary photo method. Signature of the delete method is also similar to this set primary photo method. If we look at the API endpoint of delete method, here as well we are passing two parameters. One is property ID and another one is photo ID. And also we are passing bearer token as well here. So instead of writing complete code again, to save some time, we can copy this set primary method and make the required changes here. Let's name it delete photo. And here in place of post, we need to use delete method because we are using a delete verb for this API endpoint. Also, we need to remove this blank object that we were passing as body in set primary method. But for delete method, we only need two parameters. One is URL and another one is headers. Let me split it into two lines to make complete code readable. That's it. Next, we need to use this method in the photo editor component. Go to the photo editor component and create delete photo method here. Let's copy this set primary photo method and make the required changes. Name it delete photo. Call delete photo method in our housing service. And on successful deletion of photo, we would like to remove the deleted photo from property.photos as well, so that the photo editor refreshes the photo on our user interface. So in place of this code, we will refresh this .property.photos. And to filter the property photos, we can use the filter method of an array, which accepts a callback function. And this callback function is called one time for each element of the array and return the element that meets the condition specified in this callback function. So we can use the lambda function here as a callback function. And here we would like to return an element where the photo public ID of each element is not equal to the public ID of the photo that was deleted on clicking the delete button. It should be double equal. So basically this filter method will return a fresh array after removing the deleted photo from the existing array. Our delete method is ready to be called from our HTML template now. Go to the HTML template of the photo editor component. This is the delete button, and here on click event, we need to call delete photo method that we just have created in our component and pass the property.id. And photo into this method. Also similar to the main button, I would like to disable delete button for the primary photo so that someone cannot accidentally delete the primary photo. That's it. We are ready to test our functionality now. So the first test case is passed. Both of these buttons are disabled for the primary photo. Our second test case should be that a user should not be able to delete a photo for the property that does not belongs to them. So we are logged in as Sandeep, and this first property does not belongs to the Sandeep. Let's try to delete the photo of this property, but nothing is happening. At least we should get an error alert on clicking of this button. Since there is some issue in the code, let's look at the network monitor by pressing F12 if you are using the Chrome browser. I'm getting this method not allowed error. It usually occurs when we use the wrong verb. But we are using the correct verb as well. This method is supposed to use delete verb, and we are using delete only. Got it. Seems we have called the wrong method in our service. We are calling here set primary photo instead of delete photo method. So go to the housing service. Yep, this wrong method we are calling here. Let's change it to delete photo. And try to delete the photo again. Getting an unauthorized error. Seems our token has expired and we need to log in again. Let's try to delete this photo again. Yep, we are getting the correct error. You are not authorized to delete the photo. Let's try to delete the photo that belongs to our current user. So this property belongs to the Sandeep and we should be able to delete this photo. Perfect. We are able to delete photo successfully. So for this component, setting the main photo and deleting photo functionality has been completed. Next, the most interesting topic to add a feature to upload a new photo into this component. So we are going to implement this new feature in our next video. See you in the next video. Stay tuned. Bye bye.